गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वॉन्ट टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ अंकित आचार्य, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन हसमुख गोस्वामी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग. सो टूडे माई कंटेंट इज GTU क्वेश्चन पेपर सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ वैक्टर कैलकुलस एंड लिनियर अल्जेब्रा इन डिसम्बर 2011. सो हियर इज द सब्जेक्ट वैक्टर कैलकुलस एंड लिनियर अल्जेब्रा. दिस इज माई कंटेंट GTU पेपर सॉल्यूशन डिसम्बर 2011. हियर इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. फाइंड टू वैक्टर्स इन R2 इन यूक्लिडियन नॉर्म 1 वूज यूक्लिडियन इनर प्रोडक्ट विथ 3-1 इज 0. दिस क्वेश्चन आस्क इन 2 marks. So try to understand carefully that what we have to do here. We have to find two vectors in R2 in Euclidean norm 1. That means whose Euclidean norm 1. Now Euclidean norm means what? If there is one vector x1, x2 belongs to R2. So Euclidean norm of that vector, that is under root x1 square plus x2 square, right? So that you should know that what is the meaning of Euclidean norm in R2. So we have to find here two such vectors such that norm of that vectors is 1 and whose Euclidean inner product with 3-1 is 0. Euclidean inner product with 3-1 is 0 means dot product, simply dot product, right? Euclidean inner product means simply dot product. So if we are starting with, suppose let AB belongs to RT, such vectors such that norm of AB is 1. And Euclidean inner product with vector 3-1 is 0. Okay, so we are supposing from that vector let AB belongs to R2. So and it satisfied these two conditions, norm is 1 and Euclidean inner product with 3-1 is 0. So we are taking norm AB is equal to 1. Now norm AB is equal to 1, that means under root A square plus B square is equal to 1. And whenever we are squaring on both the sides, we will get A square plus B square is equal to 1. So we will get first equation, that is A square plus B square is equal to 1. Now we have another condition that Euclidean inner product with 3-1 is 0. So that vector AB with Euclidean inner product 3-1 is 0. That means AB, inner product AB with 3-1 is equal to 0. That means simply this is a dot product, right? Euclidean inner product, that is simply a dot product. So we will get second equation, 3a minus b is equal to 0, right? So from that equation we will get b is equal to 3a, okay? And substituting this value, b is equal to 3a, put in equation 1. So we will get a square plus 9a square is equal to 1, okay? So 10a square is equal to 1. Right, so clearly a square is equal to 1/10, and whenever we find a, that is equal to a is equal to plus or minus 1/√10. So here is the answer, that this gives a is equal to plus or minus 1/√10. Now we have already b is equal to 3a, so this gives b is equal to plus or minus 3/√10. Okay, so whenever we take a is equal to plus 1/√10, we get b is equal to plus 3/√10, and whenever we take a is equal to minus 1/√10, we will get b is equal to minus 3/√10 using this equation, b is equal to 3a. So that's why these two vectors required, these two vectors, 1/√10, 3/√10, and minus 1/√10, minus 3/√10, right? So this first question, question number 1A, is complete. Now this question asks in 2 marks. In this first question, in this paper, all the question ask in 2 marks. There are 7 questions. You know that in GTU question paper all the questions are 14 marks, right? So in this question, in the question number 1, all 7 questions ask in 2 marks, and that all questions are compulsory, right? There is no option in first question. In fact, this paper is actually, you have 7 questions, and out of 7 questions you have to write 5 questions, right? So all the questions are compulsory. Out of 7 you have to write down 5 questions. So this is first question. Question number 1A is complete now. Now question number 1B. If V1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, V2 is equal to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and V3 is equal to 2, 4, 6 are 3 vectors in R3 that have their initial points at the origin. So initial points is origin. These 3 vectors are starting from the origin, right? Do they line on the same line? That we have to check. Do they lie on the same line? So V1 is equal to 1, 2, 3. V2 is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and V3 is 2, 4, 6. And the initial points at the origin, right, are 3 vectors in R3 that have initial points at the origin. Do they lie on the same line? That means these 3 vectors lying on the same line or not, that we have to check, right? Now you can see that V1, whenever we multiply V1 with minus 1, you will get V2, because V1 is 1, 2, 3. V2 is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Right? So V2 is equal to exactly minus V1, or V1 is equal to minus V2. And whenever you multiply V1 with 2, you will get V3. That means what? V3 is equal to 2V1. Right? So between these 3 vectors, you will get a one relation. This relation. Here you can see V2 is equal to minus V1 and V3 is equal to 2V1. So hence V1 and V2 have opposite directions, right? And V3 and V1 have the same directions as the initial points of V1, V2, V3 are common. They lie on the same line, right? Because you can see V2 is equal to minus V1 and V3 is equal to 2V1. That means what? All these 3 vectors are multiplied of each other, right? All these 3 vectors are multiplied of each other. So hence V1 and V2 are opposite direction, because V2 is equal to minus V1. So V1 and V2 have opposite directions, and V3 and V1 have the same directions, right? As the initial points of V1, V2, V3 are common, they lie on the same line. Okay, so this second question is also complete now. This question asking 2 marks, question number 1B. So now question number 1C, here is a question. If 7A, A is a matrix, this capital A is a matrix, 7A inverse, you have 7A inverse, inverse of 7 into A. Right, you have inverse of 7 into A, that is equal to 2 cross 2 matrix, that is minus 3, 7, 1, minus 2. First row is minus 3, 7, second row is 1, minus 2. Then find matrix A. So, solution, this question is also asking 2 marks. In this question, question number 1, all 7 questions are asking 2 marks, right? So 7 inverse of 7a is equal to minus 3, 7, 1, minus 2. Now what we have to do here, we want to find matrix A. So first of all, we are taking inverse on both the sides. So we will get 7a and then divide it by 7. So we will get A, right? It's quite simple. So we are inverse on both the sides. We are taking inverse on both the sides. So the next step is 7a, taking inverse on both the sides, we get inverse of 7a inverse, that is equal to inverse of this matrix minus 3, 7, 1, minus 2. Now you know that inverse of, if you want to find inverse of 2 cross 2 matrix, it's quite simple, right? It's quite simple that you know that how we find this inverse of this 2 cross 2 matrix. Here we have a matrix minus 3. We have this matrix minus 3, 7, 1, minus 2. Now we want to find, and that is equal to seven A inverse, right? Now we want to find the inverse of this matrix. And we know that inverse of this matrix, that is equal to adjoint of A upon determinant of A. Now what is determinant of this matrix? It's quite simple. Determinant of this matrix is minus 3 into minus 2 minus 7 into 1. So that is 6 minus 7, that is equal to minus 1, right? So here is the determinant of this matrix, and we know that adjoint, how we find adjoint of 2 cross 2 matrix? It's quite simple. Just interchange these two elements, right? Just interchange these two elements. So that is minus 2, minus 3, minus 2, minus 3, and just sign change of these two matrix, these two elements, minus 1 and minus 7. And this is adjoint of this matrix and upon minus 1. Because of this determinant, so this is equal to 2 7 1 3, right? 2 7 1 3, because we have to multiply this each elements with minus 1. So minus 2 minus 7 minus 1 3 minus 3, that will become 2 7 1 3. So here is the inverse of this 2 cross 2 matrix. So A is equal to 2 7 1 3. 7 A is equal to 2 7 1 3. So A is equal to 1 upon 7 into 2 7 1 3. Now is the matrix 1 1 0? Next question. Is the matrix 1 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 in row echelon form or reduced row echelon form? That we have to check. Is the given matrix 1 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 in row echelon form or reduced row echelon form? Now before to solve this question, I want to recall that what is the meaning of row echelon form and reduced row echelon form. Now a matrix is in row echelon form means what? It satisfied these three conditions. The first condition is the leading entry. Now what is the meaning of leading entry? The first non-zero element in the given row. So the first non-zero element in the given row, that means suppose we have 3 cross 3 matrix, and if you take first row, if first element is 0, consider the second element, right? If that element is non-zero, so that is our leading entry, right? So the first condition to be a row echelon form is leading entry. In the first row we have leading entry, below that leading entry all the element should be 0, right? Below that leading entry all the element should be 0. So to be row echelon form, a matrix to be in row echelon form, the first condition is whatever, take first leading entry in first row, below that leading entry all the element should be 0. Now next condition, second condition, whenever we are going from above to below, right? Whenever we are going from above to below, our leading entry should be left to right. It should not be from right to left, it should be left to right. Whenever we are going from above to below in the given matrix, the leading entry should be left to right. And the third condition, if there is any zero row in that matrix, it should be a bottom of the matrix, right? It should be a bottom of the matrix. So if a matrix satisfied these three conditions, right? First condition is below a leading entry, below all the leading entry, all the elements should be zero in that given column. Leading entry, whenever we are going from above to below, leading entry going from left to right, and if there is any zero row containing, then zero row should be bottom of the matrix, right? Now to become a reduced row echelon form, it's already satisfied, it should be already a satisfied this three condition to be a row echelon form, right? But there are two more conditions. First condition is leading entry should be a 1, and the second condition is in a column which have leading entry, all other elements should be a 0, right? If there is any column which have leading entry, except that leading entry, all the elements should be a 0. That means below that leading entry and above that leading entry, all the elements should be a 0. So these two conditions are more to be a reduced row echelon form, right? The previous three conditions should be a satisfied, and these two conditions more should be a satisfied. Then you can say that the given matrix is in reduced row echelon form, right? So now here is a question that given matrix is in row echelon form or reduced row echelon form. So now you can understand this is row echelon form or reduced row echelon form. You can see in the first row we have a leading entry 1, below that leading entry all elements are 0. In the second row we have a leading entry 1, below that leading entry all the elements are 0, but above that leading entry there is not 0, right? In the second row we have leading entry 1, right, first non-zero element. Below that leading entry we have a 0, but above that leading entry we don't have any 0 element. So this matrix is not in reduced row echelon form, that is clear, but it satisfied all three condition of row echelon form. You can see below that leading entry all the elements are 0, leading entry is going from left to right, there are only two leading entry in the first row and second row, and that two leading entry is going from left to right, right, clear. And the third row is a 0 row, it is already in the bottom of the matrix, right? So it satisfied all the three conditions of row echelon form, okay? But the one condition is dropped to be a reduced row echelon form, that above that leading entry all the elements are 0, that is drop here. So the given matrix is in row echelon form because the second column leading 1 in the second row but does not have zeros everywhere else in that column. So the given matrix, the simple answer is the given matrix is in row echelon form, but it is not in reduced row echelon form. Okay. So this question asks in 2 marks, and complete this question. Now we are going from question number 1E. Find the